My name is John Tan. I'm one of the nominees for the Leukemia Lymphoma Society's Man and Woman of the Year campaign. I first became involved with the Leukemia Lymphoma Society through Team and Training. Team and Training is an organization I joined in 2009 when I wanted to run a marathon. See, Team and Training takes regular people like you and I and trains them in an endurance event, events like half marathons, full marathons, triathlons, and 100-mile bike rides. And in return for coaching and training over the course of a few months, each participant raises money for blood cancer research. You know, since its inception, Team and Training has raised over $1.2 billion for LLS.
My name is Amy Abramson. I'm a senior manager at LLS in the Special Events Department, and in particular, I lead the Man and Woman of the Year campaign in New York City. So the Man and Woman of the Year campaign is so great. It's a 10-week fundraising competition in New York City. It's run in a number of different chapters across the country. And essentially, local men and women are nominated by their social and professional peers to run for the honor of Man and Woman of the Year. It's a fundraising competition, so every dollar equals a vote. Whoever gets the most votes wins. Very, very simple. The candidates run in honor of our local Boys and Girls of the Year. They are two wonderful pediatric cancer survivors. This year's boy and girl are named DJ and Denaya. Denaya is 6 years old. She's a wonderful, wonderful kindergartner. She is a survivor of acute lymphocytic leukemia, which is the most common type of childhood leukemia. And DJ, he's 9 years old. He loves to sing. He loves to dance. He is a survivor of a very, very rare form of lymphoma that he acquired when he was a young child as well. Being a part of LLS personally and professionally has enriched my life in so many ways. Just being a part of Team and Training as a participant has been a rallying point for my family. Everyone gets involved in the fundraising effort, and while none of them would even think about running a mile, let alone Ironman triathlon, they really feel just as connected to it as I do, and they've been a part of every race and been a spectator, thankfully, at every race. Professionally, it's been an incredible experience for me. I've grown a lot since I've been here. I meet people every day who are alive because of the work that we do, and I think there's no better reason to get up in the morning. There is no preventative treatment for blood cancer. It can hit anyone at any time. It's not genetic. There are no environmental factors. So what LLS does that's different from many other cancer organizations that are out there is we focus on finding cures. Focus on finding cures and making lives better for our patients. So the money that is raised by the Man and Woman of the Year campaign, which has been, since its inception in 1998, over $89 million nationally, that money goes directly to help our patient services, to help our advocacy efforts in our government, and of course towards really major research breakthroughs. Since the year 2000, 67 drugs have been approved by the FDA to treat cancer patients. 28 of those were first approved for blood cancer patients, and all 28 were put through the FDA approval process with LLS funding. 5 of those have now gone on to be FDA approved for additional types of cancer, including some solid tumor cancers.
My name is Lindsay Vogelman. I work in the corporate development department at Team and Training, which is a campaign that's part of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. I've been here for about a year now, and I absolutely love it. When I started working here, separate from my own experience with cancer, I met people. I met cancer survivors. I met patients. I met caretakers who not only did what they do every day, in and out of treatment and, you know, all of the not-so-fun stuff that comes along with it, but they put on their running shoes and got on their bike, and they still did these events. And if they can do it, I could. There was no way, after being in this environment and meeting people every day who could do it, that I wasn't going to get those running shoes and go for it. Yeah, a handful of the employees that work for Team and Training and LLS and all the different campaigns do have personal connections, unfortunately. I think it's a huge driving factor when you know, the motivation when you first sign on for this job. And if there are people that don't have personal connections, they do within 2 months of being here, because participants become your friends and your family, I think, across the board on every campaign. I've found my Facebook
news feed is filled with just now, you know, friends from that I've made from working here, and whether it be participants or staff, and they all do come, unfortunately, with their own personal connections, but you know, hearing their stories is just another like motivator that inspires us.
I'm a radiation oncologist, and it's truly, truly inspiring to come across a group of people who are so dedicated to a cause that I hold so dearly to my heart.
Okay, went to the surgeon, and the surgeon said, you have Hodgkin's, but we can fix it. Okay, so fix it. And I said, okay, it's 4 o'clock, I actually have plans, I'm going to the bar, so can we hurry this up? He's like, sweetie, did you understand what I just said? You have cancer. I'm like, yeah, but you just said that you could fix it. So we had to decide whether or not to have radiation. I was diagnosed with what's called 3B. So it was on my spleen, on my liver, which isn't great, but it's better than in your bone marrow. So I had 6 months of chemo and then 2 months of radiation. There's no true reason not to donate or get involved. There's nothing stopping you or holding you back. As I've always said, it's all shapes and sizes. It's all physical fitness levels. We all start at zero and get to 100. We all, someone could take 3 hours to do a marathon. Someone could take 7 hours to do a marathon. We all finish. Someone can do a half marathon. Someone could do an Ironman. But we all have a goal. Someone can donate a dollar. Someone can donate $10,000. It's still going to a cause, and it still helps someone like me and someone like a friend, a family member, or someone that we don't even know, but it still helps.
So a big reason I continue to do team and training is because not only does the money that we raise go to the research and development of new treatments, but it helps kind of like foster that family that you want.
They can rest assured that 80 cents of every dollar goes directly where it's needed most. LLS has a team of scientific panel who decide where the research money is going, and that means you can rest assured that it is going to where the most innovative research is happening at the time that's going to help the most people. I would say that a donation to LLS helps not only blood cancer patients, but helps all cancer patients, and even beyond that. There are drugs that were approved by the FDA that were pushed forward through funding by LLS that are now being used for arthritis, for toe fungus, for all sorts of things. I think it's really important to really remember where your money is going and to be sure that it's going somewhere that matters to you.
Our mission is to win the Man and Woman of the Year campaign by raising $200,000 for the Leukemia Lymphoma Society in order to find a cure for blood cancers and support those currently undergoing treatment. Our vision is to stand together to not only find a cure, but to stay true to ourselves and have fun while raising $200,000 for the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. So, how are we executing our mission and vision? That's a good question. And besides throwing a series of marquee and fun events here in New York City, we're really relying on social media to spread our message. We want everyone to understand that cancer can really affect everyone, and we are so close to finding a cure. We just need a little bit of help to do it. Every donation counts, and we want people to stand with us and find a cure.
And washed it away.